Hello students, I will be discussing with you the parts of geography, environment and science and technology. Now this year, as you have already seen the papers, you know that the questions were not as simple to answer as compared to the other years. And one of the reasons also became the questions that came with respect to geography and environment. So let's discuss the questions which came from these three areas one by one. I'll tell you the answers to them, I'll tell you why some answers are right, why certain options are wrong, and we'll have a general discussion on the paper. So let's begin. Question number 2, and this, as we have already seen, we are discussing set B. So question number 2 says, which of the following is an artificial lake? Answer to this is Kodai Canal. Now when you talk about the Koleru Lake is in Andhra Pradesh and is one of the largest lakes in Andhra Pradesh. It is known as the largest shallow water lake in Andhra Pradesh. Nainital is basically tectonic in origin. So that's why this is not an artificial lake. And Renuka Lake is also a freshwater lake. And it is the largest lake in Himachal Pradesh. So this also is not actually an artificial lake. The answer here is A, Kodai Canal Lake. Let's look at question number 6. Question number 6 says, which of the following is or are possible consequences of heavy sand mining in riverbeds? Decreased salinity in the river, this is true. Pollution of groundwater, this is true. Lowering of the water table, this is also true. So the answer to this will be 1, 2 and 3. So what happens with case of sand mining is that why decreased salinity will happen is mainly because if I am talking about a river which is near the coastal areas, in that case whenever you take out sand in large amounts, then the sea water will rush into the riverbed and that's why the salinity of the river will increase. So that's why one is true. Now pollution of groundwater is also a factor that happens because of sand mining. So if you just combine 1 and 2, even if you don't know whether or not lowering of water table happens, if you look at the options, you don't have an option which says 1 and 2 only. So if 1 and 2 are correct, definitely the answer is going to be 1, 2 and 3. So many a times this happens that even if you don't know the answer to the entire question, you don't know all the statements whether they are correct or wrong, two of them, if you are very confident about it, will give you the correct answer. And this is evident in this question as well. Let's go to the next question, which is question number 7. With reference to agricultural soils, consider the following statements. A high content of organic matter in soil drastically reduces its water holding capacity, which is wrong. It actually increases. Or sometimes it has no effect on water holding capacity. So that's why one is wrong. And if you just look at the options now, you have one in this, you have one in this, and you have one in this. So only option that you are left with is B. So that's why the correct answer here will be B. And anyway, if you look at statement number 2, soil does not play any role in sulfur cycle, which is wrong, completely wrong. Because half the sulfur cycle happens inside the soil. So soil has a role to play in sulfur cycle as well. Irrigation over a period of time can contribute to salinization of some agricultural lands, which is also true. So if you look at statement number 3, so what happens is when the plants use water, the sand, the salt is left behind in the soil and eventually they begin to accumulate. So that's why statement number 3 is also correct. But anyway, as I said, only the first statement itself, if you know, is wrong, then you can still answer this question. Let's look at question number 8. Question number 8 says, the Partnership for Action on Green Economy, a UN mechanism to assist countries transition towards greener and more inclusive economies, emerged at. So it emerged at Rio+20, which is 2012. So answer is B. Then if you look at question number 9, 3D printing has applications in which of the following? First is preparation of confectionery items. Let's hold on to this. Manufacturing of bionic ear. This actually is true and it was in news as well. Automotive industry for sure. So 2 and 3 we know that are correct. So if you look at the options, you have 2 and 3 here, you have 2 and 3 here. Then we go to Statement number 4. Statement number 4 is reconstructive surgery, which is correct. So 2, 3 and 4 are definitely correct. So we are left with only one option, which is option number D. Then look at question number 10. Consider the following statements. The Barren Island volcano is an active volcano located in the Indian territory. This is correct. So you have one here, you have one here. So it's either A or D. Second one says Barren Island lies about 140 km east of Great Nicobar. This is wrong because it is 140 km northeast of Port Blair. So they have just changed that statement a bit. So 2 is wrong. So this is gone. Then we are left with, so this was also already gone anyway. The third statement says the last time Barren Island volcano erupted was in 1991. This is wrong because very recently, if you look at the news articles of last year 2017, you will see that very recently there was another eruption that happened. So that's why statement number 3 is wrong. We are left with statement number 1, which is 1 only. Let's have a look at question number 11. Why is a plant called Prosopis juliflora often in news? First is its extract is widely used in cosmetics. Second is it tends to reduce the biodiversity in the area in which it grows. Its extract is used in the synthesis of pesticides, and none of these. So now, if you know about this plant is also known as Vilayati Kikar in Hindi, and it has been in news very often. So it is also called as Vilayati Kikar, and very often it has been in news because of the order passed by the Madras High Court as well, and some of the steps that were being undertaken in Delhi against this. So basically this plant is a shrub, or you can say a very small tree, which is native to Central and South American countries, and it has shown itself to be one of the worst invasive species. So because of that only, it has been very recently in news and very often in news, at least if you look at last 4-5 years. It has been grown widely in some of the areas in India, in some of the states of India, and now it has become a problem for all these states. So because of that only, orders were being passed in Tamil Nadu, in Delhi, in other states as well. And that's why it has been very often in news. So the correct option here is option number B, that it tends to reduce the biodiversity of the area in which it grows because it is an invasive species. Let's look at the next question, which is question number 12. Consider the following statements. Most of the world's coral reefs are in tropical waters. Correct. More than one third of world's coral reefs are located in territories of Australia, Indonesia and Philippines, which is also correct. Then the third statement is coral reefs host far more number of animal phyla than those hosted by tropical rainforest. This was a statement which was very, very tricky because it's almost difficult for you, or I would say almost impossible for you, to know whether or not this is correct. Because if you know, the corals are also called as evergreen forests. Of the seas, right? So from here we can definitely infer that it is going to be comparable, but we are specifically talking about animal phyla. So knowing whether or not this statement is true or false is very, very difficult. But the thing is that this statement is true, because if we talk about the 34 recognized animal phyla, 32 out of them are found in the coral reefs. So that's why the number of animal phyla found in the coral reefs is very, very high. And if you compare this with tropical evergreen forest, there you only have some 9 or 10 animal phyla which is found, which is still very diverse. So that's why even if you consider this and you compare with this, obviously it has a large number. So that's why coral reefs host far more number of animal phyla than hosted by the tropical rainforest, which is a correct statement, and that's why answer will be D. Let's look at question number 25. Question number 25 says, which of the following areas can GPS technology be used in? First is mobile phone operations, and this you are using widely, so you are very much aware of it. So one is definitely correct. Two is banking operations. Yes, for banking operations it can be used. We all know that online banking is now replacing the traditional banking, and the mobile user would want the location based service for their banking as well. So GPS can provide the exact location or the coordinates of the transaction that is happening, where it is happening. The facilities can be provided to the mobile users. So all this is possible, and that's why this is a correct statement. So one and two definitely are correct. So now, even if you don't know about the third statement, whether or not controlling power grids is an application for GPS, you need not worry about it, because you do not have any option which says one and two only. So correct option will be 1, 2, and 3. Let's look at the next question, which is question number 27. The Earth's magnetic field has reversed every few 100,000 years. Correct statement. When the Earth was created more than 4,000 million years ago, basically we are talking about, if you talk about the Earth, we say that it was formed 4.5 billion years ago, right? So this is what they are talking about. There was 54% oxygen and no carbon dioxide, which is completely a false statement. When we talk about the early Earth had no oxygen at all. It had hydrogen and helium, which also escaped over time. It had carbon dioxide because of the volcanic eruptions that were happening on the Earth in the early days. So that's why there was no oxygen. There was high amount of carbon dioxide. There was nitrogen. There was hydrogen and helium initially, which over a period of time also vanished because these two are light gases. So they escaped the atmosphere. So that's why this statement is wrong. Statement number two is wrong. So this is gone and this is gone. Next is, when living organisms originated, they modified the early atmosphere of the Earth, which is completely correct, because over a period of time they started to utilize the carbon dioxide which was in air. Photosynthesis started to happen, amount of oxygen started to increase in the atmosphere. So over a period of time, the early organisms that were there on the Earth, they started to modify the atmosphere. So that's why the correct statement here will be 1 and 3 only. Let's look at the next question, question number 28. The terms WannaCry, Petya and Eternal Blue, sometimes mentioned in the news recently, are related to. One of the easiest questions, I believe, and the answer will be cyber attack. WannaCry became very, very famous at the point when it originated. It is a kind of malware, which is basically a ransomware. So it became famous, and this is completely related to cyber attacks. One of the easiest questions. Question number 29. With reference to circumstances in the Indian agriculture, the concept of conservation agriculture assumes significance. Which of the following fall under conservation agriculture? Option A is avoiding the monoculture practices. We'll hold on to this. Adopting minimum tillage. We'll hold on to this. Avoiding the cultivation of plantation crops. This is junk. Using crop residues to cover soil surface. We'll hold on to this. Adopting spatial and temporal crop sequencing, crop rotations. Let's hold on to this for now. So what we know is statement number 3 definitely is wrong. If you look at A, B and D, you see that statement number 3 is present in all these. So we are left with option number C, which is 2, 4 and 5. The problem with this question is I personally believe that 1 should also have been included, because when we talk about conservation agriculture, we talk about crop rotation, and whenever we say crop rotation, we are trying to avoid monoculture practices. Monoculture agricultural practices basically means that you are using the same crop over and over again for a very long period of time throughout the year. So that's why monoculture is avoided in such a case. We use or we try that crop rotation happens as a part of conservation agriculture. So I personally believe that one also is not completely wrong, but given the fact that three definitely is wrong, option number A, B and D gets eliminated. So that's why we are left with option number C only, which is 2, 4 and 5. So let me briefly discuss what basically conservation agriculture is. Now, when we talk about conservation agriculture, there are couple of points which are very, very important. First is covering the soil. It can be through the previously grown crop or the crop residue that we are talking about here, or it can be through a crop which can be used as a cover for the soil, but it has to be done. So that's why point number four is very, very essential to it. Then apart from that, we try to minimize the soil disturbance by making sure that the tillage is minimum, just enough to get the seed into the ground. Apart from that, nothing. So that's why adopting minimum tillage is very, very important. Now, regular crop rotation is also very, very important aspect of conservation agriculture. So that is one aspect which I am a little confused about, why one has not been given as an appropriate answer to this. But anyhow, since three is definitely wrong, we are left with only one option, which is C. Let's look at the next question, which is question number 30, a pretty straightforward question, current affairs, and has been in use for, let's say, not less than 10-15 years. So the correct answer will be D. That is, when we talk about sixth mass extinctions, there have been five mass extinctions in the past. Sixth has been predicted, and mainly it would happen due to anthropogenic factors, overpopulation, depletion of resources, pollution. All this is already resulting in extinction of a large number of organisms. So that may lead to the sixth mass extinction. So mankind's over exploitation, misuse of natural resources, fragmentation, loss of natural habitat, destruction of ecosystems, pollution, and global climate change. So all these factors, and that's why option number D. Then you have question number 35. With reference to India's satellite launch vehicles, consider the following statements. Statement number one is PSLVs launch the satellites useful for earth resource monitoring, and these are basically what we call as remote sensing. Whereas GSLVs are designed mainly to launch communication satellites, perfectly correct statement. So PSLVs being lighter, they cannot go much higher to the into the space. They normally carry the satellites which have to remain close to the earth, and that's why these resource monitoring satellites will be launched by PSLVs so that they can remain very close to the earth and take the pictures of the earth. So that's why this is correct. And GSLVs often are used for communication satellites which are heavier. So that's why when we talk about GSLVs, we say that they carry the heavier satellites. So that's why statement number one is correct. Then, so if you look at the options, you have two options here, A and C. Then if you look at statement number two, satellites launched by PSLV appear to remain permanently fixed in the same position in the sky, viewed from a particular location on the earth. Completely wrong. They do one rotation of the earth approximately in 1.5 hours, that is 90 to 100 minutes, they complete one rotation of the earth. So that's why this is wrong. This basically is true for any satellite which is located in the geostationary earth orbit. So that's why this is wrong. So statement number two being wrong, this is gone, this is also gone. Since this was correct, you are left with only option number A. Still, let us read statement number three. GSLV Mark III is a four-staged launch vehicle, with the first and third stages using solid rocket motors, second and fourth using liquid rocket engines, which is wrong. This actually is true for PSLVs. GSLV Mark III is three-staged. I had discussed this in one of my YouTube videos also last year. So statement number three being wrong, we are left with one only, that is option number A. Then you have question number 38. Consider the following statements. The definition of critical wildlife habitat is incorporated in Forest Right Act 2006, correct? For the first time in India, BYJU'S have been given habitat rights, which is also correct. Union Ministry of Environment and Forest and Climate Change officially decides and declares habitat rights for primitive and vulnerable tribal groups. This is wrong. So statement number three being wrong, three of the statements are removed. You are left with only one and two. So even if you did not know about statement number one or two, still you know which is the correct option, which is statement A. This again was one question which was not easy to answer. This basically is done at district or state level, basically by state forest boards it can be done. So that's why Union Ministry of Environment and Forest is not associated with this. Let's look at question number 39. Consider the following: birds, dust blowing, rain, wind blowing, which of the above spread plant diseases? It basically is all of them. All of them can become a carrier of disease when it comes to plants. Next is question number 40. With reference to organic farming in India, consider the following statements. The National Program for Organic Production is operated under the guidelines and directions of Union Ministry of Rural Development. This is wrong. So for any program, and this we keep saying all the time, that for any program you have to know which is the nodal agency or the ministry which is involved with the program, and that's where they try to confuse you all the time. So same thing we saw in the last question as well, same thing we see here as well. So that's why statement number one definitely is wrong. So this is gone for you and this is gone for you. Then statement number two says the agricultural and processed food products to exports development authority functions as secretariat for the implementation of NPOP, which is correct. So this is definitely correct, and that's why you are left with only one statement, which is B. Although Sikkim becomes India's first fully organic state, this was in news last year itself, and it's a correct statement. So option is 2 and 3. Then you have question number 42. Which of the following leaf modification occurs in the desert areas to inhibit water loss? Hard and waxy leaves, correct. Tiny leaves, correct. Thorns instead of leaves, this is also correct. So answer is 1, 2 and 3, and this is a fairly simple question. So for example, if you talk about cactus or acacia, these are some of the flowering plants that you see in the desert climate, and these all have all these leaf modifications. Even palm tree you can talk about. Then you have question number 44. How is the National Green Tribunal different from Central Pollution Control Board? First, NGT has been established by an act, whereas CPCB has been created by an executive order of the government, which is wrong. When you talk about the Central Pollution Control Board, it is a statutory organization. It was constituted back in 1974 under Water Act. So that's why it is a statutory body. So statement number one is wrong. Statement two says the NGT provides environmental justice and helps reduce the burden of litigation in the higher courts. This is true. Whereas Central Pollution Control Board promotes cleanliness of streams, wells, and aims to improve the quality of air in the country, which is true. So statement number two is correct. Option will be B. Then you have question number 53. Which of the following have shrunk immensely or dried up in the recent past due to human activities? Answer is Aral Sea and Lake Baikal. So you have the option D, which is 1 and 3 only. And this is something which was actually carried out, an article was carried out in Down to Earth magazine. This time what has been seen, what I observed, is there are many questions from the geography and environment area that appeared sometime or the other in last one and a half years of Down to Earth magazine issues. This question is one of the examples the tribal issue that we talked about. Even if you go back to question number 38 that we discussed, that was also something which was discussed by Down to Earth. So there were many questions actually. There were more than 4 or 5 questions this time, which directly you can say in a way came from Down to Earth magazine, which were covered in Down to Earth magazine. So let's look at question number 60. With reference to Global Alliance for Climate Smart Agriculture, which of the following statements is or are correct? First statement says GACSA is an outcome of the climate summit held in Paris in 2015. Wrong. It actually had come into being in 2014 itself. So this is gone and this is gone. Second, membership of GACSA does not create any binding obligation. Let's hold on to this. Third statement is India was instrumental in the creation of GACSA. This statement most probably is wrong. There was no mention of India anywhere in GACSA. So we can say that statement number 3 is wrong. So we are left with 2 only. So most probable answer is 2 only. And this again was one question which was not very easy to answer, because this was not a part of general current affairs, or it's not something which was widely in news or being discussed, or it is not even a very important alliance as such. So, but a question came and it was a difficult question to answer, no doubt. So option should be B. Then you have question number 71. With reference to Indian Regional Navigation Satellite System, IRNSS, consider the following statements. IRNSS has 3 satellites in geostationary and 4 satellites in geosynchronous orbit. This is true. So we are left with these 2 statements. IRNSS covers entire India and about 5500 square kilometer beyond its border. Wrong statement. Approximately 1500. So this is gone. We are left with 1. And India will have its own satellite. So no need to even read statement number 3, because we already have the answer. Then question number 72. Consider the following phenomena. Light is affected by gravity. The universe is constantly expanding. Matter warps its surrounding space-time. Which of the above is or are prediction or predictions of Albert Einstein's general theory of relativity, often discussed in the media? Now, see, you are not being asked whether these statements are true or false. You are being asked whether or not these are predictions of Albert Einstein's general theory of relativity. So it actually becomes a question which is on the tougher side, mainly because of statement number 2. The universe is constantly expanding, and in a way I can also say that this is, now when you talk about statement number 2, this was said by Edwin Hubble. See, it was very interesting. I mean, what happened is, when Albert Einstein was giving his general theory of relativity, his calculations showed that universe should be expanding. But he could not come to the terms with the idea that the universe is expanding. He believed that universe is static. So in his equations, which actually showed that universe should be expanding, he introduced a cosmological constant. And this constant he introduced just to negate the effects or negate the equation that was showing that the universe is constantly expanding. So when Edwin Hubble, when he found out, when he discovered, when he gave his theory that the universe is actually expanding, Albert Einstein called it, or called the cosmological constant, as the biggest blunder of his life. Biggest blunder of his life. So that's why this statement is not a direct prediction of Albert Einstein's general theory of relativity. 2 is wrong. So this is gone and this is gone. Light is affected by gravity is definitely correct. You have this option. So it has to be C. That is 1 and 3 only. Third is matter warps its surrounding space-time, which is perfectly correct as per the explanations of general theory of relativity. Next, question number 73. With reference to genetically modified mustard developed in India, consider the following statements. First, GM mustard has the genes of soil bacterium that give the plant the property of pest resistant to a wide variety of pests. Then the second one is GM mustard has the genes that allows plant cross-pollination and hybridization. And the third is GM mustard has been developed jointly by IARI and Punjab Agricultural University. Which of the following are correct? Now here, if you look at this, basically it was developed by, not by Punjab Agricultural University, but under the supervision of Delhi University. So that's why statement number 3 is definitely wrong. Now if you look here, you have A, C and D which have statement number 3. So we are left with 2 only. Let's look at question number 74 next. Terms sometimes seen in news and the context topic. Belle 2 experiment, artificial intelligence, will hold on to this. Blockchain technology, digital cryptocurrency, widely in news, you should know that this is correctly matched. So we are left with these three. CRISPR Cas9, particle physics, wrong. It is a gene editing tool. Again, it has been widely in news for last 2 years. So 3 definitely is wrong. So this is gone and this is gone. We are left with 2 only. So correct option will be B. Then you have question number 75. Which of the following statements best describes carbon fertilization? So if you look at, even if you don't know what this term is, you, when you look at fertilization, it should definitely be related to statement number A. If you read it, increased plant growth due to increased concentration of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. So what happens is, due to global warming, the amount of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere is increasing. And since the amount of carbon dioxide available to the plants for photosynthesis has increased, the amount of photosynthesis is increasing, and because of which there is an increased plant growth which is happening. So that's why this term has been said to be carbon fertilization, and many a times it is also called as carbon dioxide fertilization. So statement number A is right. Then you have question number 76. Now this is something which was also very widely in news. You would definitely have 3-4 articles in the Hindu and the Indian Express last year. It was being discussed, and this answer will be Internet of Things. That you have a set of smart devices which are connected to the internet, which knows how you function. Like your alarm clock is associated with your let's say geyser and coffee maker. So what will happen is, as soon as the alarm rings, you wake up. And since these are smart devices, these are devices which are connected through a network, what will happen is that as soon as you have woken up, the alarm will trigger a geyser as well, so that the water is heated and it knows that next you are going to take a bath. And probably there is a timer in the coffee maker as well, which knows that half an hour from the time from at which you wake up, the coffee is one of the requirements that you have. So half an hour from your waking up time, coffee will be ready for you. So all these are the things which are connected through a network, and this is known as Internet of Things. So this is an example that has been given here. Correct option will be B. Then question number 77, with reference to solar power production in India, consider the following statements. First, India is the third largest. Third is wrong. So statement number 1 is wrong. Statement number 2 says the solar power tariffs are determined by Solar Energy Corporation of India. This is also wrong. So the correct statement should be D, that is neither 1 nor 2. Let's discuss question number 87. The identity platform Aadhaar provides open application programming interfaces. What does it imply? First is, it can be integrated into any electronic device. Any is a very strong word, so we'll not say that this is correct. We can say that an electronic device or your mobile phone, your tablet, etc. But any electronic device is not correct. Then second is, online authentication using iris is possible. Yes, it is possible. There are 3 ways in which it can happen. It can either be through fingerprint or iris scan, or even facial recognition, but facial recognition is not in place currently. So using iris, it is possible. So the correct answer is B. Then you have question number 97. Statement 1 says, in India, state governments do not have the power to auction non-coal mines, which is false. They do have the power to do it. So this is gone, this is gone. Then Andhra Pradesh and Jharkhand do not have gold mines. Again, false. You have gold mines in Jharkhand, Andhra Pradesh and Karnataka. So that's why, again, this is wrong. So we are left with option number D, that is 3 only. Next, let's look at question number 99. Among the following cities, which one lies on a longitude to that of Delhi? This was, I would say, one of the most difficult questions, but answer will be Bengaluru. All the others, I mean, even Hyderabad is very close, but Bengaluru is the one which is the closest. So answer will be A. So with this, we come to the end of all the questions related to science and technology, geography and environment. This year, the question paper, as I said, geography and environment were not that easy. Science and technology questions were easier this year. They came from areas which were taught, which were a part of very known current affairs. So it was an easier paper, but yes, environment and geography definitely were very, very tough this time. So with this, I end my part of discussion. Thank you very much.